Hey, welcome back to another Tech Support Spy video. As always, we appreciate you watching this video and tuning into a Tech Support Spy video. Thank you so much. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and share this video with everyone that you know, who you associate with, who you're friends with. Share it with your family. Get everyone on board with the Tech Support Spy. I got like a quick video here. I want to talk about an article here from PCWorld. We're going to talk about the best of the best, right? The best PC hardware and software of 2023 and 2024. Now, this is from PCWorld. PCWorld is a PC and technical publication and blog. You can also subscribe to them. You just go to PCWorld.com and subscribe to their news and articles. But this one is a little old. Came out in December 26th. But I wanted to quickly kind of go through this video or kind of go through this article and show you some of the things that PC World feels is the best hardware and software for PCs for 2023 and 2024. So let's take a look at this. It talks about one, the Dell Inspiron Plus 16. Now, I'm a big fan of Dell. A lot of my computers are Dells. But this Dell Inspiron Plus 16 has the 4060 GPU, the 4000 series RTX NVIDIA cards right now are some of the most popular graphic cards out right now for gaming and high performing graphics. So look at the price tag, $1,249. That seems reasonable for a gaming laptop, especially if it has a 4060, but they are picking this as probably one of the best laptops to get for 2024. The Falcon Northwest Frag Box. And I kind of heard a little bit about this. This is kind of new. Well, I don't think it's kind of new. I think these came out in like 2006, 2007. I have to Google it, but these are basically a mobile desktop. You can carry this or walk this around town or walk it into the airport, I guess, as luggage, but it's actually a mobile desktop PC. So kind of expensive, about $3,000 for these, but yeah, it's basically a mobile desktop PC that you can carry around. If you want to go to your, you know, for Thanksgiving, you're going to your grandparents' house for dinner for Thanksgiving, and you want to play your favorite video game on your PC, just take your PC with you. Go over to your grandma's and eat Thanksgiving, sit down at the kiddie table, and eat you some macaroni and cheese. So it's a mobile desktop. Take a look at the Frag Box. You can Google that and see more about the Frag Box mobile desktop. They also talks about the Asus ROG, Republic of Gaming Alley. It's a handheld gaming system. Kind of reminds me, it looks like the Lenovo Legion Go. It's not the same device, but that's the first thing that I thought of when I first saw this. So it's kind of like a handheld system, video game system. You know, I think the very first handheld game system, I can't remember, I have to Google it, but I want to say it was... I feel like it was the Nintendo Game Boy. Am I wrong on that? Somebody comment below if the Nintendo Game Boy was the first mobile handheld gaming system. I have to Google that, but I don't feel like doing it right now, being lazy. But viewers, let me know, which was the first mobile handheld gaming system? Was it the Game Boy, or was it like maybe an Atari handheld system? I can't fully remember. Anyway, we are going to move forward out of this article. Then PC World talks about the best CPU right now. Now, I'll be honest, Intel is a good CPU. AMD are also good CPUs, but I'm more on the AMD side, especially for gaming. But the 14th gen, the Intel Core i7-14700K is a good chip. You know, it's a good chip as it compares to the more, like it says, the more gaming focused Ryzen 7 7800X3D. That's a good processor. You know, with its strong gaming performance, the 7800X3D was a top contender for being the best CPU to launch this year. And in fact, if that's all you're planning to do, it's still an excellent choice, especially if power consumption is a concern. But Intel's Core i7-14700K managed to nudge it aside to take our recommendation, thanks to getting four additional efficiency cores. It handles content creation task much more easily than the 7800X3D while still posting similar numbers in mini games. So if you take a look at this article, you'll get more and read more about why they feel the Intel Core i7-14700K would be the best CPU for 2024 over the Ryzen 7 AMD 7800X3D. I would still go with AMD, that's just me, but you cannot go wrong with the Intel Core i7-14700K processor. I don't want to read the whole article. It gets into some of the best antivirus. Yeah, Norton has always been like the number one antivirus security software out there. It does talk about the best SSD solid state drive, the Corsair MP700 Pro. You can get a 1 terabyte for $190 and a 2 terabyte for $325. I'm more familiar with the Samsung 980 Pro 2 terabyte SSD, but I mean, Corsair is pretty good. You can definitely get some good results using this particular SSD, as obviously it's the PCIe, the 5.0 solid state drive. You can definitely look into using this as one of your SSDs for your custom built PC or for a pre-built PC that has a PCIe 5.0 slot that you can put this SSD in. Best password manager, Dashlane. I've used Dashlane in the past. They're pretty good. I think they probably are one of the best password managing software out there. Chromebook. If you are not familiar with the Chromebook, they're loosely a pretty good priced PC that does use the Chrome OS. It's not a Windows PC or a Mac. It has its own Chrome or Google OS or Chrome OS. I'm sorry, but it's based off Google. You gotta sign into a Chrome OS. You gotta sign into your Google account to be able to access the software and programs on a Chromebook. But something to look at. Then it talks about the best Thunderbolt dock, the Sonet Echo 13 Triple 4K. Best VPN, Express VPN. Wow, I mean they've really have exploded to be like the number one VPN program. You know, there's a lot of good things about ExpressVPN. I use ExpressVPN as well. Best keyboard, the Razer Black Widow V4. So if you are highly into keyboards for your desktop computer, you like the lights, the camera, the action, and you like it to look pretty, then think about the Razer Black Widow V4. Best graphic card, Radeon RX 7800 XT. Surprised they did not mention about the NVIDIA RTX 4080 or 4090, but they are recommending the AMD Radeon RX 7800 XT. Those are right now going for $400 or $499 or $500. I don't know, just me, I'm still more of an NVIDIA guy, but the RX 7800, you cannot go wrong with this Radeon AMD graphic card. So for PC World, this is a better graphic card or recommended graphic card for 2024. Adobe Acrobat Pro DC. This should come with any Windows. It's easy to download. It's basically allows for you to view PDFs. It should be free in Windows. I don't know why they have a 19. I have to look into that. I think there's. Oh, I wasn't thinking. It's Adobe Acrobat Pro DC. So Acrobat Pro allows you to modify PDFs, allows you to modify or take a Word document and convert it to PDF. So you can do a lot of like editing and creating in the Adobe Acrobat Pro DC. I wasn't thinking all of it. I thought it was just Acrobat DC, but no. This is software that allows you to modify PDFs and convert Word documents to PDFs. So it's a pretty good software, especially if you are a business owner or a company that needs to modify a lot of PDF documentation. Definitely worth the price to purchase the Adobe Acrobat Pro DC. Best monitor, the Philips Creator Series. Going for about $499. I'm not really familiar with the Philips. I'm more familiar with like the LG TV or LG monitors. Some of the Asus monitors as well. But they're selling the Philips Creator Series as a pretty good monitor. So check it out. Best gaming mouse, a Razer Viper V3. Honestly, personally, I could care less. I'll take a Dell mouse and be able to use that and
play somebody in Call of Duty or something and still be able to win the game. So I'm not really big into gaming mouses, but if you are a big into gaming mouses, you know, if you're big into the colors and RGB lights on the mouse and you want to be able to have that speedy, quick optical sensor with your mouse, definitely something to look into would be the Razer Viper V3 Hyperspeed Gaming Mouse. All right, this should be the last recommended program here is the remote desktop software. I use TeamViewer anytime I need to like work with a customer or do a training session if they can't, not familiar with like Teams or Zoom, you know, just to kind of work with them to kind of just help them install those programs. I'll use TeamViewer or I'll use our software that we use, it's called Zoho Assist, and we'll work with them to help them install Zoom or Microsoft Teams. Remote PC by iDrive. So you can also use iDrive, another remote PC program. Best gaming laptop. They say the Acer Predator Triton 17X. Ooh, $3,600 for this PC. It's a lot of money. It has a 4090 in it. Doesn't say what processor it has in it. I'm assuming it might have either a Intel chip in it, I'm assuming, but I don't feel like looking it up. So, but that's an expensive laptop. But if it has a 4090 in it, I'm pretty sure it has a lot of other specs that helps boost this computer to be like a high performing gaming PC. So, best USB-C hub or dock would be the Dock Case Smart USB-C Hub 10-in-1. So if you get a 10-in-1, you can probably do 10 different connections in one hub, which is pretty neat. Best Windows backup, the R-Drive Image 7-1. I've actually never heard of this. Stalwart R-Drive Image has always been a favorite, but thanks to much needed interface refresh and added functionality version 7.1, this Windows backup program is now firmly at the top of our list. So I need to do some research then on the R-Drive Image 7. I'm used to just doing an image backup myself within Windows and then reinstalling Windows and then restoring my Windows off the image once Windows is installed. So I might have to do a video on this. Best webcam, the OBS Bot Tiny 2 4K. So if you're looking for like a webcam or like a desktop webcam, take a look at the OBS Bot Tiny 2 PTZ 4K webcam. Best gaming headset, the Audiz Maxwell Wireless. Never heard of Audiz, but these look pretty sweet or pretty neat. Large 90 millimeter planar magnetic drivers in the ear cups, which are a change from the 40 to 50 millimeter neodymium. I can't even pronounce that word. Neodymium. I can't even pronounce it. Sorry. Drivers I usually see in gaming headsets. Huh. I'll have to do some more research on these Maxwell Wireless headset. Best online backup, iDrive. Omira iDrive. It's like a cloud backup online. Best gaming monitor is the NOCN 27M2B. Never heard of this brand before, but might be worth looking into. Best laptop for tinkerers. Framework Laptop 13. Not too familiar with this particular laptop, but I wanted to just halfway go through this, but I've actually went through almost this whole article. So it gives a good mixture of different programs, different hardware selections for 2024. I recommend a check out this article. The article will be in the description of this video. And I hope this gives you some insight of some solutions as far as software and hardware to possibly pick up for 2024. Like, comment, subscribe, share this video with others. Help this channel grow. Comment below, help the algorithm to pick up this video. and help the Tech Support Spy channel grow. As always, thank you for watching Tech Support Spy.